My name's Chris. I'm one of the internal medicine vets here at Veterinary Specialist Services. Today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about gastrointestinal endoscopy. So your pet may be referred to have an endoscopy, or it may be a procedure we choose to do as part of your pet's workup. Endoscopy is where we go down with a camera and actually have a look, similar to in people who have endoscopy or colonoscopy. Endoscopy is minimally invasive, and it allows us to do a number of things. We may choose to do endoscopy to retrieve foreign bodies, to look for foreign objects in the esophagus or in the stomach, to look for things like ulceration and strictures, or possibly as part of an inflammatory bowel disease workup, or looking for other causes of vomiting, diarrhea, or chronic gastrointestinal signs. Endoscopy, although it requires a general anaesthetic, is minimally invasive and allows us often to avoid more invasive procedures or surgeries. Endoscopy allows us to visualise the internal surfaces of the esophagus, the stomach, and usually the first part of the small intestine. If we do colonoscopy as well, it also allows us to visualise the large bowel or the colon, and all the way up to the junction where the small intestine meets the large bowel. Sometimes while we're in there, where we choose to take biopsies of the inner lining, and so the mucosal surface of the bowel. And these biopsies that we send away to the pathologist can help us to diagnose a whole range of conditions. With endoscopy, patients may be in just for the day and go home that night, or for some patients they may need to stay in hospital, potentially prior to the procedure and sometimes afterwards. With endoscopy, there can be different requirements for the preparation, similar to in people. For upper endoscopy, so looking at the stomach and intestinal tract, this usually just means having no food for a period of time, and this might be between 12 to 24 hours. If we're doing lower endoscopy or colonoscopy, we often have a preparation period where your pet may be in hospital, or this preparation period may be at home, depending on what we're looking for, and this will be determined by your pet. Endoscopy and the results of the endoscopy, and plus or minus the biopsies, will allow us to help tailor a treatment plan for your pet to try and get the best possible outcome. Endoscopy is a very commonly performed procedure here at VSS, and one that we've had lots and lots of experience with. And this allows us to know what we're looking at and be able to compare it to what a normal patient might have, and have good technique in terms of being able to collect biopsies and see as much of the bowel as possible. In some cases, because endoscopy can only get down into the first part of the small intestine, and the intestine can be meters and meters long, sometimes we will need to look at other options to investigate other parts of the bowel. Or if we're worried about the outer lining of the intestinal wall, we may need to look at surgery or other options to investigate this also. For most patients following endoscopy, they'll be able to go home the same day. Occasionally, patients may need to stay in hospital afterwards. There's no recovery or no restriction requirements in terms of rest, so patients can resume normal activity the next day and can resume normal feeding. In conclusion, endoscopy is a minimally invasive technique that allows us to diagnose and treat a wide array of conditions. If you have any questions regarding this procedure, either its availability, concerns, complications, or risks, please don't hesitate to contact one of our team.